Thank you, sir. So, okay, my presentation is on a very interesting and a very important topic, which needs a lot of recognition and a lot of importance in the field of crime scene investigation. So, with permission from the jury members, can I start my presentation? Thank you, sir. So, my topic is basically I am discussing about the blood pattern analysis. The blood pattern analysis is considered as one of the very important evidence which signify the story behind the crime. And my topic is all about this the different aspects which is giving a very plus point while we are analyzing a blood stain pattern analysis. As we all know that blood is considered as one of the most frequent type of evidence which is significantly encountered on the numerous crime scenes by the forensic investigator. Giving a very glimpse of a very small detail, because it is very well known to everyone that blood is made up of a different components, which includes plasma, RBCs and WBCs and platelets. So the blood found at the scene of crime can be of various forms and pattern. Now, it basically depends on the type of crime, that is the violent crime or the non-violent crime. Blood stain pattern analysis is considered as a scientific method in which the blood as an evidence used for the identification of the following characteristics of the blood drops on the basis of size, shape, and other distribution. Now I'm talking about if I discuss about the nature of the violent crime that produced the blood stain pattern, which is carefully studied and examined with respect to the distribution and geometry that might give the information of the considerable, which is a valuable, so as to assist a forensic investigator to reconstruct the crime scene as well. The blood stain pattern analysis is considered as a specialized branch in forensic science. Basically, this field is not a new idea. Definitely, even in the numerous famous cases, we had applied this blood stain pattern analysis as one of the major evidences which is helpful in solving the crimes. So it's definitely not a new idea, but it requires a lot of recognition as well, so that because considering this blood twin pattern analysis giving you a major information behind the damage caused the victim, the suspect, the crime scene investigation, which we called as a corpus delicti, which we call that as a body of crime. So we can define on the basis of this single evidence. The geometry analysis of human blood stain pattern at crime scene requires much greater recognition over the past several decades. And this analysis should be reviewed as a forensic tool that assists the investigator or the forensic scientist to better understand what took place and what could have taken place during that event. Coming back to my very important connection points of this blood stain pattern analysis, the angle of impact. Now, just give me a second, sir. Yeah. So discussing about the angle of impact, if I talk about when we go to a crime scene, we see different stains. So now these blood stain pattern analysis are in the form of the spatter and non-spatter form both. Now considering the spatter form, they are like cast off pattern, they are the drip trails, they are the different classifications of blood stain. Now considering the non-spatter, we can discuss about the swipe pattern, the wipe pattern, and the pool of blood as well, which will not give you majorly the satellites and other information about the blood stain, but will give you the immense knowledge behind it. So considering the direction of the travel of these blood stain, whether it is from right to left, it is from left to right, up to down or down to up, we can detail these on the basis of the droplet satellites as well as the tail of that droplet. You can see on this picture where we had discussed a very quick review giving you that the blood where this particular lining is called as the spines. And these resultant, the outward resultant are called as the satellites. And the formation, the elongations are called as the tails. On the basis of the elongations, we can discuss about the directionality of the particular blood stain as well. Now, let's just speak about the angle of impact. So the angle of impact is measured for the identification of blood stain, which was spread and formed a pattern on the wall or any other surface. So when a small mass of blood droplet has been put into a surface by a free floating with any means, so this particular droplet will form in a spherical shape. Now these drops are commonly known as spatter. So it is very important to understand why blood creates the elongated stain and the angle at which strike. Now coming to my very third image, here you can see that these blood stain pattern has been dropped on the basis of the different degree of angle. Now considering the different degree of angle, if I just give you a very quick example, if I drop a blood with a 90 degree angle, so the 90 degree angle resultant blood stain generally give you a circular in shape. But when it decrease the number, like giving into moving to the acute angle or moving to the less than 90 degree angle, it will started giving you a elliptical blood stains with having an elongated tail as well. So these are the different droplets which has been performed on the different degree, whether 10, 20, 30, 90 and till 90 degree we had been. So if you see, as per it is moving, it is showing you a major satellites in when it comes to 90 degree. Correct. Now moving to my next image. Similarly, this image is also giving the relevance of how 90 degree and the decreased amount of a degree, which will give you the splatter. Now these last two images was performed by me during my practical working on it, where I had trying to analyze by putting the drops on the surface. So basically the surface used was paper here. Now you know that paper is a porous surface, right? So it will definitely absorb some of the blood as well. And of course, definitely that practical was not directly performed with the blood sample, but considering a liquid drop, to just understand the satellite procedure. So what I had done basically to understand the concept. And if you see in this image, and then if you see in this image or in this image, there is a slight and a very large variation, which is, if you see this image showing a lot of elongated satellites around the drop. This is because of the degree changes. This is because of the degree of variation I had been done during my reviewing work for the blood stain pattern analysis. I can also want to mention one important point here. Now in the last image here, I had been performed one of the characteristics where I had, which is called as flow of blood. So if you see, the flow of blood will give you a directionality where it is going. So in numerous cases, let's just talk about a person in suicide cases when they just simply cut their nerves. So you will find these drill patterns. You will find these lining patterns. Like suppose if someone has cut their hand from here, so there will be a possibility that this drill pattern is moving downwards, which will give you again a possibility and an idea behind how much the heinous the crime is. Last point I want to consider here, that the direction of impact. So the directionality of the droplets can be identified on the basis of the path that a particular droplet was followed if struck to a related surface. My last point to consider in this point, sir, that there is a point of convergence, which is very important to understand. That point of convergence is basically called as a two-dimensional plane, that a point where which all drops are originated. So suppose there are drops which are falling in different direction. So we definitely find out the center point of convergence of it to understand from where it started. Basically, it's the main idea behind it. So what we used to do practically, I had seen in numerous videos, or I had also studied about numerous research paper. I had gone to a very, very interesting part of it, that we simply draw a straight lines and drawing through the axis, considering one axis point, and then drawing a straight lines. Even I had in my practice work, like when I was planning to train student and just wanted to perform on my hand, I was doing the same thing when I was just take one tripod, put a thread there, and on the wall, I just patter the blood normally, and then joining the threads to understand the potential as well as the directionality of that drops, which is a very interesting part. It gives me some good results as well. Of course, they are lacking in my knowledge as well. That is why I'm still learning these concepts, because I wanted to start this as my research project and I wanted to work as a research. So considering this entire study as my particular review work and my particular itself practicing work, you can say that. Also, I would like to, very important thing I would like to mention here, that need of an hour. Yes, definitely blood stain requires a very important need, because this is very important forensic information about a crime under the investigation. And we can discuss about, if we discuss about a very famous case of Neeraj Chopra, and then there is a case of one Mumbai case also, I'm so sorry, I'm just slipping the mind of the correct name. These cases had been literally solved on the basis of the bloodstain pattern analysis. So of course, this particular evidence is one of a very key role, and most important bloodstain analysis is to support or corroborate witness statement as well. Of course, if witness is telling something, some story behind it, then these bloodstain are going to be very important factor, because why? Witness statement and the bloodstain analysis going to give you the exact information about that crime scene. Let's not say exact, but at least it will go 80% approx definitely. So that is all from my end. Thank you so much for being an amazing listener. And now I'm open for the questions. Thank you, sir.